We're getting closer to that legalization date, so that hype is building. But the street doesn't seem to be convinced in the cannabis sector. I mean, you still have naysayers that are saying that, you know, it's overvalued, mm-hmm. stocks are overvalued.
For sure.
I mean, you have market caps like pushing double-digit billions. Mm-hmm. So what would you say to the street who still doesn't have the confidence in the sector?
Look, there is some overvaluation, I think, but when you look at the global market opportunity, there are reports out there that are in and around $180+ billion. And so when you look at these market caps of these companies that are $10-15 billion, the total exposure of those $10-15 billion companies fully blown out around the world when it globalizes, that's relatively small in the grand scheme of things. And so there's upside for those companies that go and execute and do a good job at executing and have the products and have the relationships that that can go and take the globe by storm, not just Canada. Because Canada is the first federally regulated country that has both medical and recreational. And so when it proliferates around the world, the opportunity is there. And I think it's far beyond that of $180 billion when you look at all the verticals that cannabis stratifies.
Now, I guess some investors have likened this to the cryptocurrency craze, mm-hmm. if you will.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, look, there's froth, meaning there's a lot of people that are very interested in it and don't know where to put their money. But this is a consumable, and that's the difference. This, you know, it's not software. It's not the dot-com boom. I think, you know, you see this is a consumable, and it goes across the world in many different formats. And so when you look at the verticals that we're in medical, we're in rec, we're also in pet. So there's the psychoactive, which is the recreational side, and the non-psychoactive, which is more the wellness side. And so, you know, there's a lot of opportunity within both of those elements of cannabis, and there are far more cannabinoids to be exposed and understood as well. So THC and CBD are the beginning of what are the other 100 cannabinoids in cannabis are. So, you know, how that gets formulated into new products and where that goes is, you know, we're at the tip of the iceberg, and this is, as I say, embryonic right now. This is the beginning of prohibition coming out of prohibition, and that's the exciting part about this. This is Canada gets to be on the front line here.
So some of the companies that have expressed interest are the big beverage companies, mm-hmm. rather. Breakthrough recently,
yes.
has expressed interest in you. Coca-Cola, and you know, there were rumblings of Coca-Cola and Aurora, mm-hmm. Constellation, Diageo, Molson. It's getting overcrowded.
No, this is people realizing the opportunity, big corporations realizing the opportunity of cannabis. And so when you talk about Breakthrough, who are our partner and understand the opportunity within cannabis, there's a strict three-tier system in the United States. You can produce, you can distribute, and you can retail, and you can only do one. And so they saw an opportunity up here in Canada in the cannabis industry to take part in the full vertical channel. So you can go all the way from seed to sale. And so that's very exciting for them. And they're not only our retail partner where they're going to go and rep us at retail, they've invested their own money.
Indulge me here for a moment. I'm going to let you have a minute of shameless self-promotion. Why do you think Breakthrough chose CanTrust? I mean, there's a plethora of cannabis,
sure.
companies out right now.
Absolutely.
Why would Breakthrough choose CanTrust?
Because they see our discipline. Our discipline within medical has been second to none. We've owned that channel. We've become known for our medical cannabis line. And why? Why? Because we've standardized our product. We are incredibly advanced with respect to making this a real industrialized commodity and product. And so they saw the opportunity to partner with somebody who is forward-thinking, who understands markets, who understands scale, and can execute. And so when you look at our fundamentals compared to our peers, we are one of the most fundamentally sound companies out there. And when you look at the shareholder value and opportunity that has yet to be unleashed within the CanTrust stock, it's just a no-brainer for them to pick us.
So help me understand cannabis beverages per se, because it's, mm-hmm. the CBD, right? And I've heard you say that it's zero calorie,
zero taste profile.
Right.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So what does that, I guess the opportunities are endless because, I mean, you could be looking at like
Absolutely.
Flavored water.
Anything. Anything, and it stays in solution. So, you know, we've developed this in-house. And so the microencapsulation of the THC and CBD molecules are such that it you can put it in a, it's soluble. So it's something like alcohol. You put alcohol in water, it evenly dilutes and stays in solution. It doesn't separate, it doesn't sink to the bottom, it doesn't rise to the top. And so it's just like you drink a glass of water and you wouldn't know you had THC or CBD in it. And that's a great base for any beverage product. So you can build any flavor profile around that. And that's a huge opportunity for us and any beverage company that wants to plug in their portfolio of products and brands to be able to get into the cannabis space.
I'm just wondering, because beverage companies now are moving away from so much sugar in their mm-hmm. beverages. Mm-hmm. So how does this affect them?
Well, this is,
how will this play?
This is a perfect fit in so many ways.
I mean, you have
as
to
I
say that.
It is. It's just zero taste, zero calories, with an intended benefit, be it CBD or THC. So it's something that it's undeniable with respect to what you can do with it. So you know, a water-based THC drink with a touch of a flavor in it, natural flavor. So let's say you know you put some lemon in it and or you know cranberry. I mean, very very low calorie with a great experience at the end of it. And so the microencapsulation that we've done has increased bioavailability, so faster onset, so something more along the lines of alcohol, and so when you have a 5 or 10 milligram beverage that is either THC or CBD, you get the result quicker, and that's the value proposition we bring to the table, and that's the product we have right now ready to go at scale.